This is Thomas Gallagher, happily married and father of two. What you're seeing is footage of Thomas while on vacation at a Verbo with his family. He goes about his morning as any other day. However, this day will be vastly different from anything he's ever experienced. In just a few moments, Thomas Gallagher will begin feeling an increasingly painful headache and will have difficulty moving his neck. A blood vessel has ruptured in his skull, causing a cerebral hemorrhage. Not long after the symptoms occur, he yells for his wife and is promptly taken to the hospital. Once in a while, you hear about someone who succumbed to a brain aneurysm. This is a scary and unfortunate reality that no one wants to think about. At any moment, a blood vessel could rupture in your brain without warning, and there's nothing you can do to stop it. However, there are some caveats. The incidence of a cranial hemorrhage is pretty low, about 2%, with most cases happening to people between the ages of 30 and 60. More to the point, why would a blood vessel rupture in the first place? In this video, I'll explain why blood vessels rupture, how it happens, and what you can do. This is Dark Science. Today's video is sponsored by AG1. AG1 is a foundational nutrition supplement formulated to raise your baseline health by supporting the whole body, brain, and gut. Each scoop provides important vitamins, antioxidants, probiotics, and minerals that supply vital nutrition to keep your body healthy. One scoop has a required daily intake of vitamin C, vitamin E, vitamins B1, B2, B7, B12, niacin, zinc, and folate. And there's results to back it up. A 2023 study found that AG1 significantly increased short-chain fatty acids in the human gut. Short-chain fatty acids are used as an energy source by cells in your colon. They also have anti-inflammatory effects and help maintain good bacteria in your gut. In my own experience, AG1 has increased my energy throughout the day, to where I no longer need coffee to stay awake. I also have better focus and don't feel as hungry. Go to drinkag1.com/darkscience. to get a free 1-year supply of vitamin D3 plus K2 and 5 AG1 travel packs with your first purchase. Thanks to AG1 for sponsoring today's video. Blood vessels are a network of tubes that carry blood under pressure to organs and tissue throughout the body. The average pressure of blood in your blood vessels is roughly 2.3 pounds per square inch. They range in diameters from centimeters all the way down to micrometers. Blood vessels are not to be thought of as rigid, static tubes similar to PVC pipe, but rather are rubbery, dynamic tubes that dilate and constrict, known as vasodilation and vasoconstriction. They expand and contract to respond to different demands of the body. This may be to increase or decrease blood pressure, remove heat from the body, or change the amount of blood flowing to a particular organ. For example, blood vessels need to dilate during exercise to increase blood flow to muscles. After a meal, blood vessels in your GI tract dilate, so more blood can flow to the intestines to aid with digestion. Blood vessels are able to expand and contract due to their protein composition. Arteries and veins are made of specialized cells called endothelial cells. In between these cells is a matrix of proteins composed of elastin and collagen. Elastin is a very flexible protein that gives blood vessels their elastic properties. Elastin is found in high amounts in other stretchy tissue. Collagen, on the other hand, is a strong structural protein that has high tensile strength and is very rigid. This gives blood vessels strength and durability. Due to its tensile properties, collagen is found in tendons, bone, and especially scar tissue. You'll notice on healed scars that the tissue is firm and thick. It's not meant to stretch, but rather conceal and protect. This is because scar tissue contains a high amount of collagen. This is a crucial point that I'll return to later in the video. To sum it up, elastin can be thought of as a rubber band for stretching, and collagen can be thought of as a rope to prevent tearing. In the protein matrix of blood vessels, there is always more elastin than collagen, with an average ratio of 1.7 to 1 of elastin to collagen. This gives blood vessels slightly more flexibility while also having adequate strength to avoid tearing. As we age, this ratio of elastin to collagen changes, with collagen increasing and elastin decreasing. Collagen increases because your blood vessels become damaged over your lifetime. Chronic stress raises blood pressure, putting mechanical strain on the vessel walls, causing structural damage. Buildup of cholesterol in the inner lining of the vessel walls causes inflammatory damage. Both of these factors weaken the blood vessel. Your body repairs blood vessels by adding collagen to the weakened areas. This is because collagen is a strong protective protein. Cells called fibroblasts produce collagen and patch up damaged areas in the protein matrix. Like the thick scar on your skin, collagen creates a rigid protective layer on the blood vessel. However, putting more thick and elastic collagen into the protein matrix creates a new problem. Collagen doesn't stretch. It acts like a rope or cable and keeps tissue tight and restricted. Paradoxically, adding more collagen makes the blood vessel weaker. Blood vessels can be as much as 50% weaker when extra collagen is added to its composition. This weakened structure can be seen as a growing bulge or ballooning on the blood vessel itself, as the vessel tissue becomes overstretched. This ballooning is called an aneurysm. The tissue gets weaker and weaker as high-pressure blood flows through it until it stretches too much and ruptures. Now, blood vessels rupture all the time. If you've ever had a bruise on your arm or leg, it's because capillaries in that area were broken, likely from trauma. The discoloration beneath your skin is actually blood leaking out of blood vessels. And yet, it's not serious. It's not serious because these blood vessels are extremely small, micrometers in diameter, some the width of a human hair. It's when the blood vessel is larger, like an artery measuring a diameter of centimeters, that it becomes serious. With this size of artery, significant blood can be lost in minutes. If the rupture happens in a crucial part of the body, like the lungs or liver, it becomes even more fatal. But what you're probably most curious about are the blood vessels in your brain. When a blood vessel bursts inside the brain, it's called an intracerebral hemorrhage. This is the classic line of pop the blood vessel that you often hear about in fatal cases. When an artery ruptures in the brain, blood leaks into the surrounding tissue, filling it like a balloon. Accumulation of blood pushes against other areas of the brain, bruising and tearing the tissue in the process. Symptoms of an intracerebral hemorrhage will depend on the area of the brain in which the blood vessel ruptured. For example, hemorrhaging in the basal ganglia causes paralysis on one side of the body. Hemorrhaging in the occipital lobe will cause blurred vision and even entire loss of vision, if severe enough. Bleeding in the frontal lobe may cause difficulty speaking or slurred speech. If there is bleeding in the cerebellum, there may be loss in coordination and fine motor skills. Despite dire circumstances, you can survive an intracerebral hemorrhage. However, you will only survive by getting immediate medical treatment. Every minute that passes without medical intervention, the higher the chances of irreversible damage and complications leading to fatality. If the response time is within minutes following an intracerebral hemorrhage, survival is about 50%. Though an intracerebral hemorrhage is very bad, it's not the worst type of brain aneurysm there is. While a blood vessel rupturing inside the brain is dangerous in its own right, a rupture in the space around the brain, called the subarachnoid space, is even more severe. This type of brain hemorrhage is called a subarachnoid hemorrhage, the same type of brain bleed that Thomas Gallagher experienced. The subarachnoid space lies between the arachnoid matter, a protective membrane, and another membrane called the pia mater, which directly covers the brain and spinal cord. The term arachnoid refers to the web-like appearance of this membrane around the brain. When a blood vessel bursts in the subarachnoid space, blood leaks into the cerebral spinal fluid surrounding the brain. Accumulation of blood within the subarachnoid space adds more fluid volume, which increases the pressure exerted on the brain. This elevated pressure doesn't just compress a specific area, like in an intracerebral hemorrhage. It compresses the entire brain, resulting in widespread damage in a short period of time. The first noticeable symptom of a subarachnoid hemorrhage is a thunderclap headache, an excruciating headache that is described as being kicked in the head over and over. Other symptoms include a stiff neck, blurred vision, and loss of coordination. The survival rate of the individual depends on what symptoms they have. As symptoms become more severe, chances of survival decrease. A slight headache and neck stiffness following a subarachnoid hemorrhage roughly gives a 70% survival rate. Symptoms of a severe headache and mild nerve palsy decreases survival to 60%. As symptoms worsen, survival diminishes further. Loss of motor function on one side of the body and rigid limbs predicts survival of 20%. when the individual exhibits decerebrate posturing and falls into an unresponsive coma, the survival rate is only 10%. By this stage, medical intervention is almost entirely ineffective. If you ever have these symptoms, especially the early symptoms that come out of nowhere, get to a hospital as fast as you can. Time is your only advantage when experiencing a cranial hemorrhage. The sooner you receive medical intervention, the greater the chances of survival. Thankfully, Thomas Gallagher did get to the hospital in time, which is what saved his life. He was under intensive care for 10 days and made a full recovery.